Pregnancy tests, whether done at home or in a lab, detect a substance called HCG, which stands for human chorionic gonadotropin. This is found in the blood and urine of pregnant women and is normally produced by reproductive tissues at very high levels in the first 3 to 4 months of pregnancy. HCG is a hormone, and one of its purposes is to signal other parts of the body to do the things needed to sustain pregnancy. It can be detected early on in a pregnancy, so it is a suitable surrogate for figuring out whether someone may be pregnant. But how does the pregnancy test kit work? Home pregnancy kits are a type of lateral flow device, which means that when you apply a liquid, in this case urine, it flows sideways across the absorbent pad where it interacts with different reagents. Some of these reagents are attached to specific locations on the pad, so they line up with the spots for the control reaction and the test reaction. The whole process depends on HCG connecting to or binding to large molecules called antibodies, which were originally produced and collected from animal immune systems. Antibodies are selected which specifically bind to HCG, and the antibodies can also be labeled with something that we can see, like colored particles or a substance called colloidal gold. So, when the HCG in urine encounters an antibody, the two molecules will bind and continue to move down the pad until they encounter another antibody that binds to a different spot on HCG. The second antibody is attached to the test or T line, and when this binding happens, it holds the HCG and the visible antibody in place. This is referred to as forming a sandwich. When this happens, with millions of HCG molecules and antibodies, the color accumulates and forms a visible line. But what about the other line? The control line? Is that important? You bet it is. Some of the labeled antibody will get past the T line and keep going. When it encounters another antibody at the C line, this anchored antibody binds to some part of the moving, labeled antibody, forming the C line. This tells you that the reaction worked. For example, that there were enough antibodies, there was enough urine, and that you waited long enough to see a reaction. Could something go wrong? Yes. For example, HCG concentrations go up quickly in pregnant women, and after 5 to 6 weeks, there can be so much HCG in the urine that each molecule of HCG binds its own antibody, and the sandwich, one HCG molecule with two different antibodies, never has a chance to form. Also, altered forms of HCG appear, which also block the normal binding to antibodies. So the test, designed to detect early pregnancy, is really only good at specifically doing that.